Seth uses a computer for work. Describe the ways in which the following factors can affect the performance of his laptop computer: number of cores and clock speed. When we speak about the performance of his laptop computer, we generally speak about increasing the performance of the CPU. The first factor says the number of cores. How would this affect the performance of the laptop? Firstly, a core is made up of an ALU, a control unit, and all of the registers that we'd find in the von Neumann architecture. Here we have a single core. A single core can process one instruction per clock pulse. The clock is a component within the CPU that determines how fast each core can process an instruction. Theoretically, if we add more cores into our CPU, we'd be able to process multiple instructions at the same time, thereby increasing the performance of our computer. However, there are a few complications when we're adding more cores into our CPU. Let's take a two-core CPU setup, what is also called a dual-core CPU. Each of these cores can process a single instruction within a single clock pulse. A program is made up of sequential instructions, in other words, one instruction after the other. If the second instruction requires data from the first instruction, we can't necessarily run these two instructions at the same time. So oftentimes programs aren't able to run on multiple cores. Lots of programs do support multiple cores, and that is done via very smart programming. But there is still the need to communicate between these two cores. The CPU needs to understand which core is processing which instruction at a single point in time. We already know that access speed is a lot slower than processing speed in modern day computers. And that means if there is any sort of communication lines, it is by default going to decrease the performance. So, if we double the amount of cores, in this case we have two cores within our CPU, it doesn't necessarily double the performance of the system. A more common setup that we have is a quad-core setup, where we are going to run into the same problem. Whilst we have multiple cores that can process multiple instructions at the same time, we need some sort of communication lines between all of these cores. You can see we have six communication lines between these cores. So the overall performance of a quad-core processor is not double that of a dual-core processor. Let's go ahead and write out this answer for 2 marks. Bear in mind this entire question is worth 4 marks, so we only need to write 2 points for the number of cores. Each core processes one instruction per clock pulse. Sequences of instructions can be split between multiple cores, so more than one instruction is executed per clock pulse. We could also mention that more cores decreases the time taken to complete a task. The next factor speaks about the clock speed. The clock, as we said before, is a component within the CPU that manages how fast each core can process its instructions. Modern day clock speeds are generally around 3.5 gigahertz, which is equivalent to about 3.5 billion cycles per second. This number can vary from CPU to CPU. Many CPUs allow a feature called overclocking, which is the process of increasing the CPU clock speed past its default speed. For example, the overclocking speed for this CPU could be 3.8 gigahertz, meaning we can execute 300 million more cycles per second than the default speed. Overclocking can be damaging to a CPU, but we won't speak about that for now, as we're just looking at the performance of the laptop. So let's go ahead and write in the answer for clock speed. Firstly, we can mention that every instruction is executed on a single clock pulse. So the clock speed dictates the number of instructions executed per second. The faster the clock speed, the more instructions can be run per second. And there we go, that is our answer completed.